Assalamualaikum and very good morning to all my dear students. In the last video we have seen that Jody and Phone started their journey to come back to the home. And Jody was a little boy and afterwards he just started to come back at the home with the phone. Finally he got the phone in the forest and then after they started to come back to the home with the phone. Now here in beginning of his journey it was very difficult to carry that phone on his arm, but anyhow he managed to raise that phone in his on his head, on his arms. And finally what happened afterwards, he remembered that thought which is given by his father, that once you will just raise that phone, afterward that phone will be follow you, right? So that things he had done there in the forest, and finally phone also followed him. Now what happened we'll see next in this video. See, he was very sweet, but a light breeze blew through the June morning. Still he was in the forest with the phone, and it was very difficult. There he was just become very tired and weak by raising that phone on his arms. That's why he said he just become very tired and he felt sweat over there. But that the light breeze in the June morning, he was feeling there, and because of that light breeze, that the dry sweat from his body. See, cooling him, the sky was as clear as spring water in a blue china cup. That here Jody was just describing the atmosphere in that particular morning when he was in the forest with the phone. So here he said the sky was very clear in the spring water in a blue china cup. It means here it is the atmosphere in the sky he was describing here. See, he came to the clearing. It was fresh and green after the night's rain. So here he said that afterwards that the journey was very clear and very happy with the phone, and finally he also described the weather of that particular morning, right? So here he said it was very fresh, very green after the night's rain. Oh, whole night just raining was there. That's why here the sky was very clear and very fresh. The atmosphere, the air, the breeze very fresh and very clear there. So here the Jody and Phone also felt that type of atmosphere in the forest. And then see next. He fumbled with the latch and was finally obliged to set the phone to manage it. So he passed over that whole night there with the phone in the forest, and finally he fumbled. He reached right, so he fumbled with the latch and was finally obliged to set down the phone to manage it. Finally he came and he reached at the door of his house, and he just wanted to open that door of that house, his own house, and want to take some rest over there. That's why he sat down with the phone on the door of his house. See, then he had an idea. He would walk into the house, into Penny's bedroom with the phone walking behind him. So whenever just he reached at his door, so he sat down there with the phone and he was thinking about that phone. And he just thinking about that, directly I will go to my Penny's bedroom and will give him surprise with this phone. I finally got it and find it in the forest, right? So here he was thinking, I will go directly there in his father's bedroom. See, with the phone walking behind him, so he wanted to know and wanted to say to his father that phone also here with him, and that phone followed him whole night in the forest also. So here Jody was thinking about that idea about that phone and his father. See, but at the steps the phone barked and refused to climb them. When he just entered his house, he just wanted to follow that phone behind him. But what happened when he just entered and he started to climb the steps of his house? What happened there? That phone become very bark. Bark means what? Was unwilling to walk along with the phone. So here it means that phone had not that much energy. He was not that much energetic for that. So he could not able to climb the stairs of his house. That's why he felt very unwilling to climb that. He refused to climb the stairs of his house. He picked it up and ran to his father. Finally, again, Jordi raised that phone on his arms and he directly entered in his father's bedroom. Penny lay with closed eyes. Now, when he opened the door of his father's bedroom, he saw there his father was taking rest there. So he was taking rest there and his father's eyes were closed. Jordi called, "Pa, look." So he saw there his father's eyes were closed, and then after he just shouted and screamed there and said, "Pa, Pa means who here?" His father, right? So his father. So he called his mother and said, "Look," right? He gave a surprise to his father. Penny turned his head. Jordi stood beside him. When he called his father, "Pa, look," that time what happened, his father turned back towards him. And then after Jordi went near to his father and he stood beside his father, the phone clutched hard against him. Now, when the phone also had seen his father dead, that phone has clutched means what? To grasp something tightly, to catch something tightly. उन्होंने किसको पकड़ लिया? Jordi को. Why? What is the reason behind it? Why that phone was very afraid of his father? Because as we know that in the beginning we have seen his father killed that phone's mother dead. That's why. And this phone also had knew about this father. This is the person who killed my mother. That's why phone also felt and expressed the feelings of fearness there, right? So he was very fearful here about the father. So that's why what happened here, that phone clutched, that phone catch what he, that phone caught Jordi very tightly there in front of his father. It seemed to Penny that the boy's eyes were as bright as the phone's. Then Jordi's father just relaxed there to see their boys. It means who? Jordi's eyes, his own son, right? So Jordi's eyes also very clear and very bright. It was very shiny there as phone. Phone also was very happy there, and Jordi also was very happy there. So these whole things, these whole moments also become very happy there, and that's why that Jordi's father also become very satisfied and happy. He was very he was just expressed the overwhelming feelings of great joyful and happiness there. See, then next.
The cream had risen on it. वो जो मिल्क
का पेन था वहां पे भरा हुआ था, वो पेन के ऊपर जो मिल्क था उसके ऊपर मिल्क सॉरी क्रीम जिसको हम बोलते हैं मलाई मलाई आ गई थी, राइट? सो दैट क्रीम हैड राइजन ऑन इट एंड ही स्किम्ड द क्रीम इनटू द जग. सो देन आफ्टर जॉर्डी टुक आउट दैट होल क्रीम इनटू द जग, इट मींस ही केप्ट इन दैट पेन ओनली मिल्क, राइट? एंड ही पॉर्ड मिल्क इनटू अ स्मॉल गार्ड ही हैड इट आउट टू द फूड. एक छोटा सा ऐसा एक इट वाज वन काइंड ऑफ utensils we can say, right? It was one kind of utensil he kept. He just poured that milk into that small utensil and gave that right utensil to the phone. But he just had not given to directly to that phone. But how he was just giving that milk and how the phone was drinking that milk here in the next paragraph we'll see. It suddenly smelling the milk. Then when that phone was very hungry, as we know that, right? From the last 3 days he had not eaten anything, he had not drunk anything. That's why it butted. Butted means what? He something with force, right? So here he hit that utensil by his head, right? So here hurried, right, to drink that milk over there. So it butted, it suddenly smelling the milk, he saved it vigorously from spilling over the floor. Vigorously means what? Dangerously, right? So here, this phone was very hungry, it was very tired, and anyhow he wanted to eat, he wanted to drink that milk over there. That's why it was in a hurried way. We can say that first of all, what happened there? The phone directly attacked on that bowl, on that utensil where Jordi poured that milk on it. So here it butted suddenly and smelling the milk. First of all, he smelled the milk and then he started. He just attacked dangerously on that particular utensil. It could make nothing of the milk in the jar. He dipped his finger in the milk and thrust them into the phone's soft, wet mouth. But Jordi again took out that utensil on his hand, and that Jordi wanted to give that milk by giving his own way. So here, what happened? Jordi put not nothing to milk in the guard, and he dipped his finger into that milk and thrust. Thrust means what? Put them. They put them and dipped their fingers into milk and they put them into the phone's soft, wet mouth. उसके अंदर fingers milk के अंदर रख दिए and then after he just give that milk, right? He kept that his own fingers into the mouth of the phone. See, it sucked greedily. Greedily means बहुत ज़्यादा hurriedly. Here it means he was very hungry. That's why by very eagerly we can say, right? Eagerly he wanted to drink that milk, that's why it sucked it. When he withdrew them, it breathed frantically and butted him, right? So here, frantically means what? Hurriedly, quickly we can say, right? So here, that Jordi and phone was both were very happy with, and they just that Jordi was very happy with the phone because Jordi wanted to give and anyhow he wanted to raise that particular phone and he wanted to spend, as we know that in the next in the last video that Jordi wanted to play with it, to spend some time with it, as we know that he want to run with it, right? So here that all things also reminded by the Jordi in his mind, and here that's why he wanted to fill his stomach here with the milk. Next, see. So this is the dry containers like the trolley. In each Jordi just poured that milk and dipped that his fingers into this fold. He dipped his fingers again as the phone shoved. He lowered them slowly into the milk. The phone right? Just the drying kit, whole milk, right? Then after what happened, the phone blew and something and snorted. It sent its small boots impatiently, right? So from the last, you can say last few days, he had not eaten anything. That's why he had not that much energy to stand on his own feet. So here, by drinking that milk, he got some energy over there. That's why he just stood on his legs, on his hooves. As long as he had his fingers below the level of the milk, the phone was content. And as the phone had just drank that milk, and that after that, the phone just we can say got that power to just stand on his own feet. That's why finally he said, now my stomach filled with these things, and that's why he was very satisfied, and the phone was very content. It closed his eyes dreamily. Then after he started to take some rest over there, that's why after drinking that milk, he just his eyes just going to close there, because हम भी कुछ खाते हैं तो हमें अच्छा लगता है. फॉर अ मोमेंट यू कैन से वी वांट टू टेक सम रेस्ट ओवर देयर. सो सेम आल्सो फीलिंग्स क्रिएटेड बाय द फोन हियर, एंड देन सेम इन द लास्ट फ्यू लाइंस व्हाट द राइटर से, इट वाज एक्सटेसी टू फील इट्स टंग अगेंस्ट हिज हैंड. सो इट्स स्मॉल देन फ्लिक द बैक एंड फोल्ड द लास्ट ऑफ द मिल्क vanished in a swirl of the phone and bubbling. So here, in the last few lines, the writer said that it was ecstasy. Ecstasy means what? Very happy, joyful, we can say, right? So overwhelming feelings of great happiness, you can say, right? So that moment which created by the Jody and the phone into the kitchen, it was very, we can say, excitement that created by the phone here. And to feel the tongue against his head, it means that touching with of the phone's Jody's finger, right? And this both Jody and the phone here very happy, and they started to enjoy themselves with each other. It's more than flick the back and forth. Uski jo tail hai wo bhi ab hilane laga tha, right? It means here some naughtiness of that phone started here with the phone, with the Jody. The last of the milk also went whole that bowl, we can say that utensil in it that Jody kept poured that milk. It finally completed. It was vanished that milk from that bowl in a swirl of the foam and gurgling. Now here, gurgling means it's one kind of sound which created by the phone, right? So here, sound. Right? So, Jody and phone both are really very happy, and they both were just started to enjoy themselves each other. And here, phone and Jody both just started their next journey of their life. And here, we have completed our lesson. So, this is Jody's phone. Majority Kinnan Rollins has given us this beautiful lesson, and what is the moral, we can say, message of this lesson is that always to express feelings and love for the animals if you have just used and killed any one of them. So here it means here we have to create the love for the animals, that's it. So thank you students, please read this whole lesson and write all this, copy all that words meaning which I have given beside every word. So here we have completed this lesson. If you have any doubt, any question, any query, you can ask me by comment on this video. So thank you students, have a nice day.